In this next one, I'm going to solve by adding 2 to both sides. So I get cosecant squared of x equals 2. And then I'm going to take the square root of each side. But remember, when we're taking the square root to solve, like we did in quadratics when we were completing the square, we get the cosecant of x is equal to plus or minus the square root of 2. There's actually 2 solutions, because if I square the square root of 2, I'll get 2. If I square the opposite of the square root of 2, I will also get the value of 2. Now, if you don't love or have the cosecant memorized, let's try to work with some of our knowledge of our identities. The cosecant of x is equal to 1 over the sine of x, which equals plus or minus the square root of 2, we'll just say over 1. So if I want to know what the sine of x is equal to, we can say it's 1 plus or minus 1 over the square root of 2. So if you don't like working with those fractions, remember you can always try to manipulate or deal with it. All right, so let's work with the fact of the sine of x is equal to a positive 1 over root 2. We could rationalize that, or I could just work with where the sine function is positive. Remember, that's going to be in the first quadrant and in the second quadrant. And if I want to know what that is, it's the opposite side and the hypotenuse. And hopefully that looks like a familiar angle of pi over 4 and 3 pi over 4. All right, and then we also want to solve for when the sine of x produces a negative 1 over the square root of 2. We're going to have the same angles measured, but this time we'll have negative 1 root 2 and negative 1 root 2. So we know also in our solution set is 5 pi over 4 and 7 pi over 4. Now, yes, we could write out 4 full answers because we want all solutions of pi over 4 plus 2 pi k and 3 pi over 4 plus 2 pi k, and label all the other ones. But do you notice how they're nicely distributed? In between each and every one of these angles is 90 degrees, or pi over 2. Because they're evenly distributed here, I can instead write my solution as pi over 4 plus that pi over 2 now, that's the interval that we're doing those rotations, times, we'll choose any letter, let's say m in this case, where m is an integer. It wouldn't be wrong to write all 4, but just remember there's going to be overlap when you write all 4, and this is a shorthand way. I know for students this is a confusing concept, so we will work on this when we practice on Tuesday to understand when we can write different intervals that are not just a full revolution of 2 pi. So don't worry if you don't completely have that down. We will practice that on Tuesday when you're back.